students, welcome back to your English class. Students, in this class we are going to start the sentence. I mean, this is the second part of the sentence. So in this class we are going to learn the kinds of sentences according to the structure. So let's get started. Students, first of all, there are three kinds of sentences according to the structure. We have done with the kinds of sentences according to the function. We have learned that there are four kinds of sentences according to the function. That is declarative, imperative, interrogative and exclamatory sentences. Right? So, now in this class, we will read about simple sentences, compound sentences and complex sentences. So, let's begin with the simple sentences. So, what is simple sentence, students? A simple sentence has only one independent clause. Now, students, if you remember, in the last class, we have learnt that what is independent clause, isn't it? Independent clause is a clause which do not need the support of another group of words to make it meaningful. Means it can stand alone as a complete meaning, right? So, a simple sentence has a independent clause, right? So it has a subject and a verb and also conveys complete sense. You can see some example written over here. He loves to play basketball. She does not use a computer. She always forgets to do her homework. So these are the three sentences which has single independent clause and conveying the complete sense and also has a subject and verb, isn't it? So this kind of sentences are called simple sentences. Clear? Now if we will move forward, there is compound sentence. So what is a compound sentence? Student, a compound sentence has two independent clause. It means there are two independent clause, means there are two group of words that will convey the complete sense. Okay, so the independent clauses are joined by coordinating conjunction. Okay, the independent clause are joined by the coordinating conjunction. And now what are the coordinating conjunction? To understand it, you can see fanboys. So fanboy, where F stands for, A stands for and, N stands for nor, B stands for but, O stand for or, Y stand for yet, and S stand for so. So, the compound sentences are having two independent clause and they are joined by the coordinating conjunction. And what are the coordinating conjunction? You can learn them very easily with the word fanboys. Clear? Now you can see some example. I saw Ram yesterday, but he didn't see me. So here, these two sentences are the independent sentences and they are joined with the word but and which is coordinating conjunction. Clear? Similarly, you can see the second example. John wants to lose his weight, yet he eats chocolate daily. So John wants to lose his weight, this is independent clause, and again he eats chocolate daily, it is also independent clause, but we have added two independent clause with a coordinating conjunction, and that is yet. So this is compound sentence. I hope it is clear to you. Now let's move forward and understand what is complex sentence. If you will see complex sentence, a complex sentence has an independent clause, okay, a dependent clause. So, a complex sentence always has a independent clause and a dependent clause. Means, there will be two group of words, one group of word will convey the complete sense and another group of word will not convey the complete sense but some sense. Okay, the two clauses joined by a subordinating conjunction. If you remember, in compound sentences, we have learned that two independent clauses are joined with the coordinating conjunction. But here, two clauses are joined with the subordinating conjunction. Clear? Subordinating conjunctions. For example, because, that, when, until, though, although, while. Okay. So these are the example of subordinating conjunction. For example, you can see, while Tom reads novel, Jack reads comics. So here, while is the word which is connecting two sentences. So this is a subordinating conjunction, and this is called a complex sentence. When I was young, I used to run very fast. So when I was young, so this is dependent clause and this is independent clause. So when I was young, I used to run very fast. So one independent clause and a independent clause are joined together with the subordinating conjunction, that is when. Clear? So this is also a complex sentence, right? So in short, we can say that simple sentences are having one independent clause, compound sentences are having two independent clause, and complex sentences are having one independent clause and a dependent clause. So I hope it is clear to you. Now students, on the basis of these sentences, we are going to learn paragraph writing. Clear? So paragraph writing comes under writing skills, right? So what is writing? Writing helps you to improve your vocabulary and regular your practice of it. It will be quite useful in mastering the language skill. It means if you will learn the writing skill, you will be able to enhance your vocabulary as well as you will be able to master the language skill. Clear? So now, what is a paragraph? Student, a paragraph is a group of closely related sentences that develop a central idea, and it is a series of sentences that are organized and coherent and are all related to a single topic. Okay, means in paragraph writing, there is a topic given to you and you have to write the sentences, and the sentences must be closely related to each other. Okay, now let me give you an example. That is a paragraph on my friend. My friend is Jeff. He has a sister named Mary. We attend the same school and we live on the same street. Jeff likes dog. He has a pet dog. His name is Ben. Jeff's parents are Mr. and Mrs. Brown. They are very nice to me. I like them very much. So this is a short paragraph. Okay, so I think you understood what is the paragraph writing and how to write a paragraph writing. Okay, now students, there is a homework for all of you which you all have to do in your grammar notebook. First of all, student, let me tell you that you have to separate your grammar notebook into two parts. Divide into two parts, first for the grammar section and the second for the writing section. Okay, in grammar section you have to do this work. So identify the kinds of sentences as simple, compound or complex. I am sure that you will learn these sentences. He lost his money but he didn't lose his patience. So these are the six sentences you have to identify as simple sentence, compound sentence or complex sentence. Clear? And the next homework is to write a paragraph writing on my school. So I have already told you, you have to divide your notebook, and the first topic which you have to do in the writing section is my school. Paragraph on my school. So I hope everything is clear to you. If you find any doubt, you can ask me through WhatsApp. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye. Stay home. Stay safe. We'll meet in the next class.